Dear students, in the last lecture we talked about how John Dryden expressed his views on literature or drama in particular through essay on dramatic poesy. We also discussed that essay is written in the form of debate or interlocution between four characters. Each of them expresses his views on literature, especially a drama. So today we are going to discuss the views proposed by Crites. And Crites here defines the ancient or the Greek dramatist. So let us start our discussion with the character Crites. Character Crites, who is Sir Robert Howard. And here through the character of Crites, John Dryden wanted to propagate his views on the nature of ancient dramatist. Particularly, the ancient dramatist here refers to the dramatist from Greek and Romans. Essay is in the form of debate, it is in the form of interlocution. After the definition of the play by Lycidas, so definition of the play is the basis of the discussion. Here the Crites starts his discussion. Crites argues about the nature of the ancient dramatist. So Crites here defends the ancient means Greek and Roman dramatist. He defends ancient dramatist or playwrights. So ancient stands for Greeks and Roman dramatist. So he starts, the English playwrights, English dramatists, they may feel that they are superior and they are equal to the ancient dramatists. So it is a thought, it is a feeling of English dramatists or the playwrights. They consider themselves to be equal or superior than the ancient writers, ancient dramatists from Greek and Roman era, but in reality they are not superior, they are not equal to the ancient dramatists, ancient writers of Greek and Roman age. Ancients have been superior than the English dramatists, because all over the world ancient dramatists have been considered as a role model. So all the writers of the world, for them the ancients were the models, and they followed their style, they followed their way of writing the play. So it is incorrect to think that the English or the contemporary writers of the John Dryden, they are superior or they are equal to the ancients. Ancients are superior, ancients are far ahead compared to the moderns or the writers of the John Dryden time, because the ancient writers have been treated, ancient writers have been considered as a role model, and all over the world they have been imitated by the writers. So none can surpass ancients. So not only the British writers, not only English writers, the writers of other part of the world, they cannot surpass ancient dramatists, ancient writers. Ancient writers are imitated, ancient writers are followed everywhere. After that, Crites further added that ancients have been imitated. And the cause of imitation, why the ancients have been imitated, he provided a reason why the ancients have been considered as a role model, and why all the dramatists across the globe, across the world, imitated or followed the ancients. A simple reason provided by the Crites. Crites here, we know that he stands in the support of ancients against the moderns. Compared to the moderns, ancients are superior, they are role model, they have been followed by all over the world, and the reason is that they wrote better than the others. So why ancients are considered as a role model? Crites added that the ancients were better, ancients dramatists were better and that is why they are considered as role model. They have been imitated, they have been followed by others. So writers like Homer, Sophocles, then Achilles, Euripides and Seneca, they have been treated, they have been considered as a role model by other writers of the world, and that is why the ancients are superior, ancients are better. The writers like Homer, writers like Seneca, writers like Achilles, Euripides, they are considered as better, they are considered as a role model by the English writers and all writers of the world. So why the English writers do not like the ancient? The simple thing is that the Christ put here, the Christ added that the poor production in England has been malice against ancients instead of praise. So why the English writers were unable to produce the work which is equal to the ancients? Why the English writers or their work was poor, it was not of good quality? The reason provided by Christ is that the ancients were good, British writers were poor. And why they were poor? The simple reason is that the English writers have malice against the ancient instead of praise. So instead of praising, instead of appreciating the qualities, instead of appreciating the writings of the ancient, the English writers have some ill thoughts, malice against the ancient writers like Homer, Sophocles, Euripides or Achilles. And so instead of praise, there is a malice, and this is malice is the cause of ill production or the production without quality in English literature compared to the ancients. Then after that, Christ here defends the ancients in respect of three unities. According to the Christ, the ancient writers observed, they followed minutely or intently three unities. Unities of time, unities of action and unity of place. So this is a comparison between the ancients and the moderns. In comparison with the ancients, moderns are poor as far as the observance of three unities, namely unity of time, unity of place and unity of action. So place of ancients were nearest imitations of nature. So ancient writers, the place, the work produced by the ancients, it was very close, very near to the nature, and they observed the unities very carefully. So in this regard, ancients are superior, ancients are good, ancients are considered as role model, for they give importance to the law, importance to the observance of three unities. Then the Christ added, so ancients' plays had more than one underplots or subplots. So their plots have more than one plots or the subplots or underplots, but they were kept subservient to the main plot. So in ancient dramatist, one can come across a number of plots. There can be a complex plot, there can be number of underplots or subplots, but subplots or underplots are never given a priority by the ancients. So they have been kept subservient compared to the main plot of the play. So there are number of plots, there can be subplot, there can be underplots, but all these subplots or underplots are kept in a control, and they are never allowed to supersede the main plot of the play. Then the main plot and the subplots have been fused together towards the end. So there is no disparity, there is no confusion as far as the mingling of subplots and main plot is concerned. They have been brought together, they have been fused together, they have been mingled together at the end of the play. So we cannot say that there is not a proper mingling of subplot and main plot. On the contrary, they have, and since they have properly kept in proportion, both the main plots, underplots, main plots, subplots or underplots, and they have skillfully united them at the end of the play. After this, the Christ also advocated, the Christ also here considered ancients superior to the moderns or the writers of the English, in the sense, in the time of John Dryden, in contemporary Europe, in the age of John Dryden, in Europe and England, none had equaled Euripides, Sophocles, and Seneca in tragedy. So, three dramatists, three writers of the ancients, they have been specifically mentioned here by the Christ. So, none was able to overcome the writers like Sophocles, Euripides, and Seneca as far as the tragedy is concerned. So, these three writers, their contribution in the tragedy is of immense nature. They have contributed a lot, and none of the writers from the Europe and England can go near to them. After that, in comedy, Aristophanes, Plautus, and Terence were better compared to the contemporary writers. So both in form, that is in tragedy and comedy, ancients are considered as superior compared to the moderns or to the writers of the John Dryden's age. Then the very bad plays produced in contemporary England prove that ancients are the best, and imitating them is a virtue. In the age of John Dryden, after the Restoration, after 1660, here the modern writers have produced the plays which do not have good quality. The plays are of poor quality. We cannot call them as masterpieces or literary pieces. And ancients are the best all the time, and imitating them is virtue. So here the Christ gives upper hand to the ancients in comparison with the contemporary writers or the English writers, and in comparison with the ancients to the modern writers, he asserted that ancients are superior, ancients are worth imitation, and one should imitate them. Imitation of ancients is to be considered as a virtue. One cannot have a slander, one cannot have malice against the ancients. So this malice or this slander, this defaming of ancients is going to make the play imperfect. So imperfection is not a good sign of play. In order to bring perfection in plays, it is essential we have to moderns are expected to appreciate, moderns are expected to praise ancient writers, rather than defaming them, rather than pulling their name into a mire, and rather than having malice against them.